Hello friends, today I'm gonna give you some tips and recommend some useful tools to double your productivity. The first one will be Tap9. It's an AI code completion tool that works on any IDE like VS Code, Sublime, any JetBrains product, and others. And it supports all modern programming languages and understands which language you are working on according to current file type. And recently, Tap9 announced their new next generation AI. It's really exciting because in this new feature, its completions are much faster and it's able to complete all functions at one time. I'm gonna give some examples using VS Code and JavaScript. To do that, I'll install the Tap9 extension. As you can see, it's being used by millions of developers. After installing the extension, let's try to find out its capabilities. I'm gonna open a JavaScript file and create a user list. As you can see, it predicts what I'm gonna write next. I will say ID. And as you can see, it recommends name, email, and I'm gonna write here a password. Let's create one more. Now it says ID should be 2. I'm gonna give a different name. Perfect. I will change the password. It feels like it's reading my mind. And one more. It will be Jane. It's that easy. Now I want to create a function that adds a new user to the list, like this. And as you can see, it recommends the push method. I will directly pass the user. It can also help you to write your comments. And that's all. It takes seconds to create functions. Let's create months array. As you can see, it recommends all those names and it saves a lot of time. We can also create the number list in the same way. From 1 to 9, like this, I will say make 1, all elements of numbers array. And I'm not even writing anything, I just use the tap button. And it's awesome guys, we spend hours every day writing code, and sometimes it's really overwhelming. Having an AI completion tool will definitely save a lot of time and increase your productivity. And Tap9 is the best I've ever tried. It has a free forever subscription plan. And the free model is based on the world's most trusted repositories. So basically what happens is, they find the most reliable and high-quality Git repositories on every Git platform and train their AI model using millions of lines of codes. This is how it gives us the best recommendations. And the paid version, which is Tap9 Pro, provides more advanced and next-generation AI. And this AI is trained on a billion lines of open-source code. But the most important thing is it learns your coding patterns and habits. It means the AI model focuses on your code, your coding style, your naming conventions, functions, and it makes suggestions based on your coding routine. And it's incredibly useful because most of us are working on a specific language or a framework or a stack, and we are writing same codes again and again. And this necessarily lowers our productivity. But after using Tap9, you will be able to focus on new functionalities instead of boring imports, definitions, and functions that you always use. And don't forget, the more you use Tap9, the more accurate completions you will get. And also, you can choose any of your Git repositories and train your AI model using those codes. It's really useful, especially when you have a coding team. By the way, your privacy is really important to Tap9. It doesn't collect any part of your code and all your data is stored on your machine. So if you want to get more details about Tap9, you can find the link in the description below and you will get a 50% discount using that link if you want to use the Pro version. My second recommendation will be note-taking apps. Note-taking isn't just about writing to-do list and putting a checkmark when you are done. It's about staying focused and making it easier to remember information. Unfortunately, being a good developer requires learning different things every day and staying up to date. And of course, we cannot keep everything in our mind. I recommend that you write down everything you learn daily and keep them organized. To give you an idea, I want to show you how I take notes. First of all, I have a folder of ideas, and it contains everything related to my work as well as my YouTube channel. For example, create a productivity video for YouTube or create an excellent portfolio website. And below that idea, you can write small details about it. And also, I have a research folder, and there are new technologies in it that I need to research later. While working, we all come across some great libraries, frameworks, or other interesting technologies. However, there isn't always time to check all documents or read some blog posts about them. So what I do is type the name of what I want to search for later and some questions about it in my mind. And I have folders for training notes for specific topics. Let's say you are learning a new language and you are always having trouble with arrays. Taking little notes about the arrays will always help you to remember what you are struggling with. Of course, you can always Google your problems, but believe me, it's the best option to learn something. It's like a preparing for an exam. You can read it from any website, but if you write it down, it will be much more effective. And you can do the same thing for common mistakes and errors. We all have certain errors that we can never remember even though we look for them every time. So instead of going to Stack Overflow each time, you can write the error code and a short description and the solution. After a while, you will see that it's much easier to remember. Of course, these are not my real notes. I don't want to disclose my private notes. But when you create them, make sure that they are well organized, otherwise it might look like your desktop. And the other suggestion will be task management apps. I will not give any specific advice as there are tons of great software out there like Jira, Trello, Asana, Monday, and other alternatives. They all are great. If you are working with a team, you probably already use one of these, but even if you are working alone, I highly recommend choosing one of them and starting projects with it. Because planning is one of the most important parts of development and it actually makes everything more organized and much faster. If you are a developer team, you can use any task management tool and organize your plans instead of wasting time with long meetings or email threads. But if you are a freelancer or if you don't have any job and you are still learning to code, you should still use it because learning how to manage your time and how to plan a project is a huge plus. When you apply for any job, you will have an advantage over other developers. If you ask me what I like best, I use Trello the most. I've used it for years. Basically, I got used to it, but as I said, try them all and choose the one that suits you best. And the other one will be related to GitHub. We all use GitHub to organize our code, but mostly we don't use its productivity enhancing features. For example, shortcuts. Let's say I want to check a specific file in a repository. Instead of clicking each folder one by one, I can just press T button, and now I can search for any file. Or if you want to find something in a repository, press the slash button, and write what you exactly want to search for. And all results are here. I also want to recommend a really useful extension to navigate GitHub repositories, and it's OctoTree. After installing this extension, you will be able to navigate your code as you do in the VS Code. If you are a team member, it's annoying to write the same commands over and over again. What you can do is save your comments for next time use. After that, it will be easier to reply to your conversations. Of course, there are many more GitHub tricks, but I just wanted to show you how you can increase productivity by learning shortcuts. If you want me to create a video on more GitHub tips, just let me know in the comments. By the way, Don't forget to check my VS Code Shortcuts video to learn how to save more time while writing code. And the next tip is to create reusable code pieces for the feature. As I said, we don't want to repeat the same code. To save more time, you can separate the codes you use most often. For example, form inputs, login and register pages, authentication functionalities, or whatever you want. Do not try to take them from your previous project. Instead, create simple boilerplates and publish them on a GitHub repository as different branches. In this way, you won't need to remove any code pieces, it will be just copy and paste. Especially if you are using a library like React, it's gonna be a lifesaver. You can create small components and use them later for other projects. And also you can create a fake data generator, and you can create JSON lists whenever you want. And my other recommendation is break reminder apps. Again, there are many options such as break timer, awareness, stretchly. By the way, I'm gonna share all of them in the description below. But my favorite is timeout. It's completely free and you can set a reminder for small or bigger breaks. On my computer, I use a micro break reminder every 15 minutes for small stretching, and a regular break reminder every 2 hours to get up and do some small exercises. Also, if you really focus on one task, you can skip the break. I know most of you don't care about these types of apps, but working too long without taking a break actually reduces your productivity. On top of that, it can have a toll on your mental and physical health. Trust me, using this app is like brushing teeth. Once you get used to it, it becomes a part of your life. Okay, that's all for today's productivity tips, guys. If you want me to create the second part of this video, you can let me know in the comments. There are many other tips and tools you can benefit from. If you learned something new today, please like the video and don't forget to follow Lama Dev social media accounts. I hope I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.